Hi, it's Brandon. Today we're here at Lumber River State Park, and today we're gonna check out some really interesting black water. So let's check it out. Hey, Sean.
Hey, Brandon.
That water's really black. That can't be normal.
Yeah, it really is unusual. There's two main places on Earth we find black water rivers, in the Amazon River Basin and here in the southeastern United States. The black waters of the Lumber flow for 115 miles, crossing from North to South Carolina and eventually emptying into the Atlantic Ocean. There are also blackwater rivers in Florida and Mississippi that drain into the Gulf of Mexico. Still, across the world, blackwater rivers are pretty rare.
But is it dirty?
No, it's actually quite clean. Waters are designated as National Wild and Scenic Waters, which means there's no dams and no major human changes to the river's natural flow. Much of the swamp forest along its banks are protected. The forest filters pollution, roots keep soil from eroding into the river, keeping that black water clean.
Why is it black? It kind of reminds me of tea.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's actually the same process going on with tea, although I wouldn't drink it. It starts with the buildup of plant materials like sticks and leaves in the swamp forest. As rainwater soaks through, natural chemicals from plants called tannins drain out and stain the water brown. Tannins are the same chemicals that give us the brown color of sweet tea when water drains through the tea leaves. Despite that dark appearance, the Lumber River is a healthy home for animals that are adapted for life in the water.
I wonder how the fish and other animals see through that black water.
Well, they can see, but it's true that the sunlight doesn't travel as far through the black water as it does a clear water river. Even in a clear mountain stream, fish have a special adaptation that's like a sixth sense. Along the sides of fish, from gills to tail, is a sense organ called a lateral line. It looks like a line of pinholes in the scales. The lateral line senses slight water movements to help fish find food and avoid predators. In a blackwater river, the sense of smell and the lateral line are probably even more important for fish.
What about the swamp forest? Can you go hiking out there?
Oh yeah, on our state park hiking trails, you can. The swamp forest is a wetland with water-loving plants and waterlogged soils. Stay on the hiking trails or you're likely to lose a shoe in the mud. Even the park's trails can get flooded, especially after strong storms. While the forest is flooded, even more of those dark-colored tannins are dissolving into the water.
What else lives in this blackwater river ecosystem?
Well, some of the can't-miss producers are these bald cypress trees. They can grow more than 6 feet across and live for over 1,000 years. The older bald cypress trees tend to be hollow as their inner heartwood decomposes. Giant, hollow trees are great habitat for owls, raccoons, bats, and wood ducks. In the water, we find turtles, river otters, and I've even seen a deer swim across the river. The Lumber River blackwaters are really unique, just like the Amazon River.
I'm wondering, how can I explore my neighborhood like we did today?
Right, well, you may not have a blackwater river nearby, but I bet you can find a wetland in your neighborhood. Look for some low-lying areas that tend to puddle up certain times of the year, and see if you can notice different kinds of plants growing around that neighborhood wetland. I also like to make forest tea. So out, collect leaves and sticks and put it in an old jar, fill that with water, and watch how it changes color over a week, 2 weeks, just like these blackwater rivers. Just don't drink it.
So basically we have a river of tea out here.
Absolutely, thanks to the swamp forest ecosystem here at Lumber River State Park.
Well, thanks for explaining it.
Yeah.
I'm really thirsty for the ride home. Can I take that with me?
Sure, but don't drink it. It's not been treated.
I'll take it
anyway. But it is forest tea.
It's fine, I'll take it.